Hello, this is Father David, here with day 10 of the Dormition Fast 2023. Today's meditation comes from Saint Germanus, the Holy Father Germanus, Archbishop of Constantinople, in his first homily on the most venerable Dormition of the Most Holy Mother of God. He says this, "To us Christians, then, who reverence you in our Christian faith," he's speaking to the Mother of God, "show mercy of your unchanging patronage. We rightly consider your falling asleep as entry into life, O Mother of God. And we believe you dwell with us still in the Spirit. For in times of tribulation, you are near, and we find safety in seeking your help. And when it is time to rejoice, you are joy's sponsor. Whenever we find ourselves completely under your maternal care, we cannot help believing that you live among us. Just as the thirsty person hastens to the spring, every faith-filled heart runs toward you, burning to fill himself with your gracious help. And again, just as a breath of air fills a person's nostrils with life, so the breath of every right-believing Christian bears you on his lips. For we do not draw life from breathing the air to the same degree that we draw safety from the protection of your name. So, the text of Scripture is fulfilled in Christ and in you, which says, you are the breath of our nostrils. We shall live in your protection and in breathing you." A quote from Lamentations, chapter 4, verse 20 in the Septuagint, the Greek text. Now, this is, of course, a beautiful, flowery eulogy for the Mother of God. She is, for St. Germanus, in the work of God's grace, everything that Christ is. And for some, it may be a bit difficult to hear, especially those last lines. The text of Scripture is fulfilled in Christ and in you, which you are the breath of our nostrils. We shall live in your protection and in breathing you. And I think it's necessary to look at this and to say, you know, this is what it means when St. Paul himself says we are the fragrance of Christ in this world. We are called to be his hands, his feet, doing the very things that he did, being about the activity that he was about doing in the world. To go and to speak the good news of Christ's overcoming of death, to pray, to minister, to give food and drink and relief to the hungry, the thirsty, and the afflicted, to bring those who are lost to the light, to salvation, to the Holy Church. This is what it means to be indwelt by the Holy Spirit, to be a bearer of the Holy Spirit, and to take that Holy Spirit out into the world and to bear the fruit that he would bear through us into this world. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You know, this past Sunday for the Transfiguration, in many Orthodox churches, we bless fruit on that day. And it is a feast of the glory of God being made manifest from Christ, which he always had with him, but the disciples were able to see it. They were permitted to see it. For us, this also points to what we ourselves are destined to be, what the Mother of God herself is now, body and soul glorified in heaven, shining and radiant. She began now to manifest the fruit of the Spirit in this life, beautifully and more than any other created being, by the grace of God through the Holy Spirit. This is what we are called to do, to just as she was, to follow her example and be the fragrance of Christ so that others, if they look at our life and we are being faithful to Christ, they can say to us, you are the breath of our nostrils. We will live in your protection and in breathing you. And so by God's grace, we can share in that work that he has for all mankind. And that, as St. Paul says to St. Timothy, whom he says to this young bishop, give yourself over to the preaching of the word of God and to prayers, because in doing so, you will save yourself and your hearers. Not, of course, saying that St. Timothy was Christ, any more than we would say that the Mother of God is Christ, but to say that they share in Christ's saving work. And so let us all be that fragrance of Christ, that sweet-smelling fragrance of Christ in the world that comes to remind people, to show people that God is with us, that God has come down to be with us, to be united to us, that through him and through the work of all of his holy ones, we might be saved. So Lord God bless you. Lord willing, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.